Well, that was Taylor, and with us now is Stephen Budd. He's a manager for some of the world's leading artists and music producers, also co-chairman of the Music Managers Forum. And Stephen, we were just chatting. I'm going to let the audience in on what we were talking about, which is this whole question of sort of who's the goodie and who's the baddie in this arrangement, because Taylor Swift emerges as the real sort of, you know, the artist's saviour, doesn't she? And Apple are then sort of painted as a rather negative, measly company in all this, right?
Well, I think they've managed to avoid a PR, what could have turned into a PR disaster, because if the idea that artists weren't going to get paid for the first 3 months of the service, and that filtering down to younger artists who really need that income, up-and-comings, and smaller labels, independent labels, that would have had quite a bad effect. And imagine you lost a quarter of your annual earnings. That would have had quite a bad effect. But it's kind of managed to turn it around, and they said, we're listening. But I think that Taylor getting up and making the statement that she did in a very brave way, not just for herself, but for artists across the board, has been a bit of a game-changer. So, but it's not the whole thing is not over yet, because there are other people. It's only a week to go before launch. There are other people who've still got to agree to license this service, including some of the song music publishers and other services.
What were Apple being mean on this? Or do you think they'd actually thought this through? Was it a mistake, or were they trying to just skimp and deprive artists of money to make more money for themselves?
That's difficult to say. One can't think necessarily that Apple Music is going to be the main point of profit generation for Apple. What it does do is help sell iPhones and other Apple services, which is what they really want to do. So it's another example of a technology company building off the back of music, which we've seen so many times. But at least they've been good, reasonably good partners for the music industry, and have delivered quite a lot back, and they've helped bring us out of piracy into genuine sales. So, you know, there's two sides to every story.
It's a huge amount of responsibility, isn't it, for somebody like Taylor Swift? I mean, she can do no wrong at the moment. Bluntly.
Yes.
And when you think that she, you know, she sort of made, if you like, the world's leading company change its mind, you do sort of think, oh my God, you know, what else could you be changing? You know, the rest of the world's ills sort of sit somewhere on her shoulders.
Well, she should go and join that new women's political party, shouldn't she? And I think she'd have quite an effect there if she did. But, you know, the artist, I think nobody really wants to be seen upsetting artists and really making them angry, because, you know, you want to have a situation where people are collaborating with each other. And I think that by putting her foot down in the way that she did, she's managed to bring people around, and actually the right result has come out of all of this.
Really interesting to speak to you. Thanks for coming in.
My pleasure.